Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主耶稣圣名说话。
Once again, I thank God, that we are able to study the book of Revelation.
感谢神，我们能够一起学习启示录。
We mentioned about God's servants, yeah, revolve around the throne of God.
我们已经提到了神的仆人围绕在他的宝座周围。
In the chapter 22 of Revelation, we can see that they are able to serve God freely.
那所以在22章就能够看到神的仆人很自由自在的侍奉他。
I want you to read chapter 22, verse 3 again.
我们来读22章的第三节。
And there shall be no more curse.
以后再没有咒诅。
But the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and his servants shall serve him.
而在城里会有神和羔羊的宝座。
I think the statement is important. The first statement is said, there shall be no more curse.
我想这里面的这第一句话非常重要。以后再没有咒诅。
You know, when the earth or when our ancestors were cursed because they sinned.
我们知道当我们的祖先因着罪被咒诅。
So you find that in the perfect church.
所以我们就能够看到在完全的教会里。
There shall be no more curse, meaning there shall be no more sin.
以后再没有咒诅的意思就是不再有罪。
You find that, you know, those who have reached the level of perfection that God desires have shaken themselves off freely, completely from sin.
那我们可以去看见那些已经达到完全的这个境界，侍奉在神面前的这些人，他们已经将自己身上所有的罪都甩开，是自由的。
We find that it requires a great effort.Not only on their parts, but also requires God's help.
我们明白，也能明白，这需要下很大的功夫，不仅仅是我们个人的部分，也需要神很大的帮助。
We know that God always gives us graces, right? Time to change ourselves.
那神他都会给我们恩典，会给我们时间来去改变自己。
It will come a time that if we remain unchanged, then God have to do the work of phasing out.
但是如果我们都没有去要改变自己，那神他就会需要将我们去移除。
Now I want you to read Zephaniah.
好，我们来看西番雅书。
Zephaniah, we read the last chapter, chapter 3.
西番雅书来看最后一章就是第三章。
We read from verse 11 to verse 13.
读11到13节。
Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 11 to verse 13.
西番雅书13章11节到13节。
In that day, you shall not be shamed for any of your deeds in which you transgress against me, for then I will take away from your midst those who rejoice in your pride,And you shall no longer be haughty in my holy mountain.
十一节，当那日，你必不因你一切得罪我的事自觉羞愧，因为那时我必从你中间除掉矜夸高傲之辈，你也不再与我的圣山狂傲。
God's holy mountain obviously points to the church.
那这里说的神的圣山当然就是指着教会。
You find that God is going to do a very radical kind of work, you know, to remove the proud and the haughty.
那我们在这里可以看到神他要施行他的工作，要将这些矜夸高傲之人从他的这个中间除掉。
We ask, who can remain in the church of God?
那所以我们就要去问了，那谁能够在神的教会里面留存呢？
To put it slightly differently, who can be part of this perfect church of God?
就是我们换个方式来问谁能够与神的教会有份呢？完全的教会有份呢？
We read verse 12.
读十二节。
I will live in your midst a meek and humble people, and they shall trust in the name of the Lord.
十二节，我却要在你中间留下困苦贫寒的民，他们必投靠我主我神，我耶和华的名。
I think the Chinese rendering is quite different.
那我想，中文这里的这个写的不太一样。
My version said a meek and humble people.
在英文里面，它其实是说柔和谦卑的人。
So anyone who is not meek and humble, or who has not, adopted, you know, the nature of Christ being meek and humble, then obviously, the person cannot remain in the house of the Lord.
那所以那些不柔和谦卑、没有主的样式的人，当然就没有办法留在完全的教会里。
You find that these are also people who trust in the name of the Lord.
那我们也能够看见，在主，在主有份，与主教真教会完全的教会有份，也是那投靠他、相信他的。
So meaning, you know, they follow whatever they are told to do.
那他们遵行了他们神要他们做的事情。
Again, we can look at Revelations chapter 14.
那就让我们可以来翻回到启示录的十四章。
We read verse 4,
第四节。
Revelations chapter 14, we read verse 4.
启示录十四章第四节。
Now, the second part, it says, these are the ones who follow the Lamb wherever he goes.
第四节的第二个部分，这里说了，羔羊无论往哪里去，他们都跟随他。
These are the people who trust in the Lord. Yeah, they follow every instruction that God gives to them.
这些是相信、投靠神的人，不论神给他们什么样子的指令，他们都是照做。
Now we back to Zephaniah.
再翻回来看西番雅书。
Please come back to Zephaniah chapter 3.
西番雅书第三章。
We read verse 13.
我们读十三节。
Verse 13.
十三节。
The remnants of Israel shall do no unrighteousness, and speak no lies, and nor shall a deceitful tongue be found in their mouth. For they shall feed their flocks and lie down, and no one shall make them afraid.
十三节，以色列所剩下的人必不做罪孽，不说谎言，口中也没有诡诈的舌头，而且吃喝躺卧，无人惊吓，无人惊吓。
From the scriptures, it's clear that you know the perfect church will, how can I say, will consist of people like they are called the remnants, you know, those who remain in the faith.
那所以在完全的教会里面，会这群人，他们是剩下的人。
Now, so if we want to be part of it.
所以如果我们今天要成为这群人的一部分
So we must make sure that we do no unrighteousness.
我们一定要确保自己不做罪孽。
We must do whatever we can to ensure that our work is pleasing in the eyes of God.
我们要确保自己所作所为是蒙神喜悦的。
You know, righteousness represents the standard of God.
因为公义是代表神的标准。
So we must do all things to please God.
所以我们要做一切的事情来蒙神喜悦。
You find that, you know, In the last day, the perfect church will consist of people who do no unrighteousness.
那所以我们可以去发现，在末日的真教会里面，会有那群人，他们是不做罪孽的。
Today, if you look at the church,
今天我们看教会
we do experience some confusion in the church at times.
在教会，我们有时有刻会有一些困惑。
I would say this is almost like a global phenomenon as far as the true church is concerned.
那我觉得这应该是以一个全球的现象来看的。
Why is there so much confusion in the church?
为什么在教会有这么多迷惑呢？
Because we are not righteous, to be honest.
那事实上是因为我们不够公义。不够有益。
We always try to, how can I say, try to reason for ourselves. Yeah.
因为我们经常会需要去找理由去解释自己。
Or to justify our actions.
或是去让自己的行为去称义，觉得自己没有问题。
We need to understand, yeah, you know, God does not function in this way.
但是我们要去明白神他运作的方式不是如此。
What God wants to see is have we done his word?
神他想要看到的是我们有没有去行出他的话。
For example, in the church, God says we need to love one another. Have we done it? That is what is important to God.
就像神对我们说要彼此相爱，我们在教会里面或是自己生活上是否真的有照做。
If we have not done it,
若我们没有做到，
then we are not righteous in God's eyes.
那我们在神的眼中就没有义。
So we must do righteousness in the community of faith.
那所以我们在这信仰的团体里面要去行公义。
I want you to read the passage.
然后现在想让各位来读一个经节。
We turn to First John.
我们来看约翰一书。
Chapter 3.
约翰一书第三章。
First John chapter 3.
约翰一书第三章
we read verse 10, yeah.
第十节，
In this the children of God and the children of devil are manifest. Whoever does not practice righteousness is not of God, nor is he who does not love his brother.
第十节，从此就显出谁是神的儿女，谁是魔鬼的儿女。凡不行义的就不属神，不爱弟兄的也是如此。
You find that John is very clear about this.
可以发现约翰他对这个道理非常的清楚。
It's like he did not leave any reservation. He went straight to the point.
他没有任何的保留，他直接切入要害。
This is the children of God. In this, the children of God and the children of the devil are manifest. You know who are the children of God and who are the children of Satan.
他很清楚地去写出来谁是神的儿女，谁是魔鬼的儿女。
I guess we all want to be God's children.
我相信在座的各位都想成为神的儿女。
I want to be a child of God.
我自己个人，我当然想成为神的儿女。
I don't want to end up, you know, being a child of Satan.
我不想要在最后变成魔鬼的儿女。
But in order to maintain this status,
但是若我今天想要去保留这样的名分。
John says we must do practice righteousness.
约翰这里告诉我们一定要行义。
Now we need to understand this.
我们要去明白。
Well, we do what is right in the eyes of God.
当我们做神眼中看为义的事。
You'll find that our actions will produce love.
我们会发现自己的行为会产生爱。
Because in doing what is right in the eyes of God, we have to overcome ourselves.
因为做神眼中看为正的事情，首先我们要战胜自己。
We have to put away the way we think.
我们要将自己的思想放置一边。
More importantly, we have to put away our fleshly desire.
特别是我们要能够攻克己身。
So when we are able to do that to please God,
那所以今天若我们做神眼中看为正的事
，then you see that whatever we do will produce love.
那不论我们做什么。都能够去发现这结果是爱。
So righteous act in the eyes of God produces love.
所以神眼中公义的事情会产生爱。
So when we see that there's no love in the church,
所以当我们
in the family,
所以当我们看到在家庭在教会里面没有爱。
We need to come back to the fundamental questions.
我们要回到最根本的问题。
Do I do righteousness before God?
我们是否有行神眼中的义事。
If we do that, surely love will begins to come out from us.
那若我们真的有这么做的话，爱它一定会产生出来。
So you find that in the perfect church of God.
那所以在完全神完全的教会里。
No one will do unrighteousness.
没有人会行罪孽。
You know, I think we need to, help ourselves to understand, yeah, that the church is the body of Christ.
我想很重要的一点是我们要去明白教会是基督的身体。
We are part of the body of Christ.
我们是基督身体的一部分。
When we love the church, we love one another, actually we love ourselves.
当我们爱教会彼此相爱，事实上我们也是在爱自己。
When we do righteousness,
当我们行公义，
we are helping ourselves to come before the Lord.
我们是在帮助自己来到神的面前。
This is very important.
这个非常重要。
So we must learn to curb our fleshly desire.
那所以我们要去克服自己的罪性。
Pride and arrogance.
骄傲和自大。
Must be completely subdued.
一定要 让这些罪性去顺服。
Just like what is stated in the book of Zephaniah.
就像在西番雅书里面所说到的。
So only the meek and humble shall remain.
这里说了，只有柔和谦卑的人才能留下。
We read verse 13 again.
我们再来读十三节。
And the second part is there, and speak no lies, nor shall a deceitful tongue be found in your mouth.
他说不说谎言，口中也没有诡诈的舌头。
Sometimes we find it hard to curb our tongues.
有时候我们觉得好像很难去制服自己的舌头。
We say, how can we control our tongues?
有时候我们会去问如何控制自己的舌头。
First, we must tell ourselves to do what is right in the eyes of God.
首先要告诉自己做神眼中看为义的事。
And to speak what is edifying to the church community.
要说出能够造就教会团体的话。
If we can, help ourselves to speak words in this way.
那如果我们今天能够以这样子的方式来说话。
You find that, the church will become a very nice place to be in.
那你会发现教会是一个会让你觉得很舒服的环境。
When we do what is right in God's eye, when we speak what is pleasing to God.
那当我们今天做神眼中看为义的事，说他喜悦的话。
In the process, you find that our hearts will become purer and purer.
那在这个过程里面，我会发现自己的心一直在被洁净。
We know that when we first believe in Jesus,
那当我们回想最开始信主的时候，
we are given a heart of purity.
我们是被赋予了一颗清洁的心。
This purity of hearts comes from God.
这个清洁的心是从神而来的。
I want you to read Acts chapter 2.
我们来看《使徒行传》第二章。
Acts chapter 2.
使徒行传第二章。
We read verse 46.
我们来看四十六节。
Chapter 2, verse 46.
使徒行传二章四十六节。
And so continuing daily with one accord in the temple and breaking bread from house to house, they ate their food with gladness and simplicity of heart.
四十六节，他们天天同心合意，恒切的在殿里，且在家中擘饼，存着欢喜、诚实的心用饭。
If we think a bit more about what is described in this verse,
那如果我们再去深入的去思考这一节，
you find that for a church to reach this level of perfection is never easy.
会发现让教会要去达到这完全的这个境界是很困难的。
Everyone is able to sit together in gladness, to eat and to share.
你看这在这里，这个每一个人，大家能够同心合意，存着欢喜的在这里互相分享。
It's like there's nothing to hold them back.
就好像没有什么是能够阻挡他们的，挡在中间的。
Because of the simplicity of heart that Christ has given to them.
因为他们在这个心里有一颗简单，有颗诚实的心，是神基督给他们的。
We know that there are problems in the church.
那当然，在教会里会有问题。
But God has also given us this power yet to transform ourselves.
但神他也赐给了我们力量，能够去更新自己。
Not only we need to pray to God.
那我们不仅仅要去向神祷告。
We must also, I use the word demand ourselves to do what is right in God's eyes.
而是我们要去要求自己做神眼中看为正的事情。
Meaning to do righteousness in the community of faith.
那就是在信仰的团体里要去行公义。
So when we do that, you'll see love.
那如果我们这么做的话，就能看见爱。
Like what is stated in the book of 1 John.
那就像这个约翰一书里面所说到的。
If there is no love in our family, in the church, it means that our acts is not right in the eyes of God.
若在教会，在家庭里没有爱，就代表我们的行为并不是属乎神的。
God will not be happy with us.
神他也不会喜悦我们。
All of us want to be saved. I want to be saved.
我们每一位都希望蒙拯救。
We all want to come before the throne of God.
我们都想要到神宝座的面前。
Not just by coming to the church. Spiritually speaking, we must be close to God.
不仅仅是来到教会，而是在属灵的程度上，我们要来到神的面前。
So if we demand ourselves to do righteousness,
所以若我们今天要求自己
To speak gracious words to one another.
来对彼此说恩惠的话。
Then you find that the church is a wonderful place to be in.
你就会觉得教会是一个令人愉悦、很舒服的一个场
景。We can truly say that we are the revival or the restored apostolic church.
我们就能够说我们是真正的复兴了使徒的教会。
Because there is this simplicity of heart amongst all of us.
因为在我们中间，我们众人都有这颗简单诚实的心。
So who can remain in the mountains of the Lord?
那所以谁能够留存在神的圣山上呢？
Those who do righteousness.
就是行义的人。
Right. Okay, now we know that as God's servants, we must learn to face ourselves correctly.
作为神的仆人，我们要很诚实的能够去面对自己。
You know, sometimes we don't want to face ourselves.
很多时候我们都不愿意面对自己。
If we don't face ourselves, how are we going to face God?
但是如果我们自己都不愿意面对自己，又如何能够面见神呢？
How can we come before His throne?
我们如何能够去到他的宝座前？
I want to share with you some examples based on the book of Psalms.
我想和各位分享几个在诗篇里的例子。
We tend to the book of Psalms, chapter 119.
我们翻到诗篇119篇。
The book of Psalms, chapter 119.
诗篇119篇。
This is the longest chapter in the entire Bible.
这个是在圣经里面所写下最长的一章。
If you have time, please read this chapter, and you see that the word servant appears countless times.
那如果各位有时间的话，希望我们都能够去仔细的读这一篇，而就会发现其中仆人被提到了很多很多次。
Okay, we just look at a few examples.
我们来看几个例子。
We read verse 23.
首先来看23节。
Verse 23.
119篇23节。
Princes also sit and speak against me, but your servant meditates on your statutes.
虽有首领坐着妄论我，你仆人却思想你的律例。
Now, you know when you read this Psalms, it divided into many mini sections.
当我们在读这篇的时候，它分了几个段落。
Each section is like a mini story.
每一个段落都是独立，都是一个小故事。
It's like an encounter that the psalmist has gone through.
那是每一个
经历
啊。
Okay, now here the psalmist says, "Princes also sit and speak against me."
那就是这些作诗人这里说这个首领妄者作者妄论我。
What would you do if you were this servant here?
那如果你是这里的这个仆人的话，你会做什么呢
？Probably after you heard what people say about you, you know the fire within you will start what? Start burning.
那可能当你听到有人这个在妄论你的时候，你的心中就有这一把火。
You said you know your blood will start boiling.
你的这个血液开始这个沸腾。
It becomes so angry.
非常愤怒。
Why all these people are talking about me?
你会觉得说这帮人到底在说我什么
？You become very angry, more and more angry. Why? Because you keep thinking about it.
当你越一直去想，你就越来越生气。
But you look at a true servant of God. Look at his mindset. It's different.
但是你会看到这仆人你看到他。不同的思想。
And this is what we need to do as well.
那这也是我们需要去做的。
We have said this before, The church can be a very difficult place.
那我们有提到了，教会它可以是一个非常困难的一个地方。
This is a reality.
这个就是个现实。
But we cannot run away from the church because this is the place where you get salvation.
但是我们不可以就这样子逃离教会，因为教会是让我们能够得救恩的地方。
So you have to look at the church correctly.
所以我们要用一个正确的角度去看教会。
Yes, there may be difficulties in the church.
是的，在教会里面一定会有不容易。
What can I learn from all these difficulties? What does God want me to learn?
但是我能够从这些困境、困难里面去看见神 要我学习的。
Or you can think about how can I help to resolve all these difficulties by the grace of God.
又或是我们如何能够靠着神的恩惠来去解决这些困难。
But obviously not according to our own ways, but according to the way of the Lord.
那当然显而易见，不是靠着我们自己，而是按着神的旨意去做。
So if we can overcome,
那所以如果我们能够去克服
all the difficulties that we face in the church,
我们在教会里面遇到的所有的困难，
then surely we shall come before the throne of God.
那我们就一定能够来到神宝座前。
Now coming back to the example I mentioned,
那我们回来看这个刚刚提到的例子。
You find that this servant here is very different.
你可以看到说，这里这个仆人他非常的特别。
He knows how to control himself very well.
他知道如何去控制自己。
Instead of reacting to the situation,
不仅他没有去对他所遭遇的这个境况来去有反应。
He starts meditating on God's statutes.
他反而是去思想神的律例。
You know the word meditate is a very special word in the book of Psalms.
那思想思考在诗篇里面是一个非常特别的字。
How are we going to meditate?
我们要如何去思想呢？
We turn to the book of Psalms, chapter 1.
我们翻到诗篇第一篇。
Chapter 1.
诗篇第一篇。
We read verse 2.
我们来看第二节的话。
Chapter 1, verse 2.
第一篇第二节。
But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. Now, if you are using NKJV, there's a footnote given.
那如果你是用这个NKJV 的这个英文版本的话，你会发现就是有注释啊。
那 meditate means ponder by talking to ourselves。
那这个思想这个字就是当你在想的时候，你在对自己说话。
Or you teach yourself。
你在教导自己。
You teach yourself with the law or with the word of God。
你用神的话、神的律法来教育自己。
So in a difficult situation,
那所以在一个特别非常困难的
处境， we must all learn to use the word of God to teach ourselves.
我们一定要去会用神的话来教导自己，来开导自己。
So in this way, you find that the adverse situation that we are in will not easily affect our heart.
那这样我们就能够去感受到逆境对我们不会有太多的影响。
We will not easily react to a hostile situation.
我们不会很轻易的就去在这个敌对的处境里面去发作。
I guess this must become part and parcel of our behavior to use the word of God to teach ourselves.
那我想这已经要用神的话来教育自己，要成为我们的这个一部分。
And I guess, you know, when we encounter, you know, anything difficult, and we think about God's word, it becomes something natural.
那所以如果我们真的能够如此做的话，很自然而然的，在我们遇到任何的处境，我们都能够去思想，去用神的话来教自己。
You know,There are psalmists in the Bible when they are attacked, you know, and they obviously they became angry.
那在诗篇里面也可以看到很多作诗人，他们遭受攻击也非常的生气。
They were the servants of God.
他们是神的仆人。
But how did they react?
但是他们的反应是什么？
We look at one example.
我们来看一个例子。
Then we'll come back to Psalms 119.
看完之后，我们再回来119篇。
We turn to Psalms.Chapter 39.
诗篇39篇。
Psalms chapter 39.
诗篇39篇。
This is a psalm written by David.
这个是大卫他所写的诗。
We read from verse 1.
我们从第一节开始读。
I said, I will guard my ways lest I sin with my tongues. I will restrain my mouth with a muzzle while the wicked are before me.
第一节，我曾说我要谨慎我的言行，免得我舌头犯罪。恶人在我面前的时候，我要用绝环勒住我的口。
Muzzle is only for dogs. For
这个绝环是只是给狗用的。
I'm not sure if you have seen, you know, people who like you take their dog out like pit bull terrier, they will put a muzzle on.
不知道各位有没有看到，就是很多人去遛狗的时候会用这个绝环去套住它们。
You know pit bull, a very fierce dog.
对，那个那个比
比
利犬，
那凶狗。
那个
对，不能 muscle，
对，很凶的，很有一种很凶的那种，也是比利犬嘛。
This is what you know the psalmist did to himself.
对，但是大卫在这里写说，他要用这个绝环去套自己的嘴巴。
Okay, verse 2.
那第二节。
I was mute with silence. I held my peace even from good, and my sorrow was stirred up.
我默然无声，连好话也不出口，我的愁苦就发动了。
But you know, outward restraint cannot really control what is in the heart.
但是外在的束缚没有办法去控制内心的。
Yes, he may muzzle his mouth.Or even by his tongue, not to say anything.
对啊，他可以勒住自己的口，他可以去，又或是咬自己的舌头，不说出任何的话。
But he cannot stop his sorrow from being stirred up.
但是他没有办法去抑制他心中的愁苦。
Now we read verse 3.
第三节。
My heart was hot within me while I was musing. The fire burned. Then I spoke with my tongue.
我的心在我里面发热，我默想的时候，火就烧起。我便用舌头说话。
But thankfully, he did not speak to man first. He spoke to God.
但是，很好的是，他没有先对人说，他是先对神说。
So from verse 4 onward, you see that is a prayer.
那所以从第四节开始就是大卫的祷告。
Obviously, sometimes we can be grieved.
那当然，有时候我们会忧愁、忧伤。
But we must learn to control our emotion.
但是我们要。一定要学会控制自己的情绪。
In a difficult circumstance, if we are able to speak to God first, then we shall be victorious.
在困境，若我们能够首先来向神说话，我们就能够得胜。
So you find that the psalmist are back to 119.
所以，让我们回来看这个119篇的这个作诗人。
So he taught himself with God's statutes, with God's words.
他用神的律例、神的话来教导自己。
I just want to ask you a question.
我想问各位一个问题。
Have you ever criticized someone else before?
你有没有是否批判过他人？
Who has never criticized anyone before? Raise your hand.
那没有从未批判过别人的，举起你的手。
I have criticized people before.
我批判过他人。
It means that I'm not perfect.
因为我这是代表我不是完全的。
So sometimes I'm also criticized by others.
有时候我也被他人批判。
So when I'm criticized,
所以当我被批判
，Do you think it is right for me to be angry?
你觉得我生气是合理的吗
？No, because I've done it before.
那是不是的？因为我自己也这么做过。
So when you look at ourselves in this way, we see that we are imperfect.
那所以，如果我们这样子去看自己的话，就能发现自己不这么的，并不是完全的。
How can we come out from this situation?
那但是我们如何能够从这样子一个处境里面去跳脱出来
？Teach ourselves with the word of God.
也就是要去用神的话来教导自己。
You know, sometimes you find that words from the pulpit may not be effective on us.
那有时候我会发现，在讲台上的道理这些话，对我们没有什么影响。
It's not that the speaker, you know, has not spoken, you know, the word of the Lord. No.
那不是说这些正道人他们说的不是神的话。
Because we shut our ears.
而是因为我们关上自己的耳朵。
We don't want to listen.
我们不想听。
Even though we're sitting down there, we just shut our ears.
而即使我们是坐在这里，我们的耳朵是关上的。
But if we are able to use the word of God to teach ourselves,
但是如果今天我们能够用神的话教导自己
it means that there is a great improvement on our part.
这对我们来说就是一个很大的一步进步
because we want to be close to God.
因为我们想要亲近神
we need to understand, you know, situation in the church if they are not resolved within our own self, yeah, they can actually draw us away from God.
我们要去明白，在教会里面发生的事情，若我们在自己的内心里面没有 从根本上去解决的话，这其实会让我们离开教会的。
The only way to resolve is by counting on God, by using the word of God to teach our heart, to teach ourselves.
唯一能够去解决问题的根本就是要靠神的话，用神的话来教导自己。
Do what is right in the eyes of God. Do righteousness.
要去做神眼中看为义的事情，要去行公义。
Okay, now we look at another example.
我们再来看另外一个例子。
The same chapter 119.
那同一篇。
We read verse 37.
读三十七节。
And 38.
还有三十八节。
Verse 37.
三十七节
Turn away my eyes from looking at worthless things and revive me in your way.
求你叫我转眼不看虚假，又叫我在你的道中生活。
Verse 38.
三十八节
Establish your words to your servant, who is devoted to fearing you.
你向敬畏你的人所应许的话，求你向仆人坚定。
Today we find that our eyes, are attracted to many things.
今天我们发现自己的眼目被很多事情吸引。
Like in our life, you see that so many things can actually cause our eyes to sin against God.
那在我们的生活里面有很多的事情会让我们的眼目来犯罪得罪神。
You know that the world is so immoral.
我们知道这个世界是很混乱败坏的。
There are so immoral things.
有很多不道德的事情。
So if we are not careful, our eyes can sin.
那所以我们今天不小心的话，我们的眼目会犯罪。
So here the servant, the psalmist, asks God to turn his eyes from looking at worthless things.
那所以这里这个作诗人他求神帮助他转眼不看这虚假。
Okay, if you look at the phrase worthless things, meaning things that cannot benefit you, or in our context.It means they cannot benefit us spiritually.
那你看他这里写的这个没有价值的事情，这些都是对我们没有任何益处，也不会让我们灵性有成长的事。
Today, we may not sin, like we not break the Ten Commandments, but there are so many things in the world that we love.
那今天我们可能不会犯十戒，但是在这个世界上有好多我们爱的事情。
We have a lot of habits.
有很多的习惯
that we know can draw us away from God.
这些习惯是我们知道会让我们将神的关系远离的。
I can take, our times away from us.
那是会让我们花很多时间在上面。
So we must stop looking at all these worthless things.
那所以我们一定要让自己的眼目不再看这些虚假、这些无意义的事。
And the psalmist here says, "Revive me in your way."
那这里作诗人又说。求你让我在你的道中生活。
Establish your words to your servant.
并且坚定你所对你仆人说的话。
You find that when you look at worthless things, that the word of God will begin to disappear from our hearts.
当我们很多时候都在看这些虚假、这些没有意义的事，很多时候神的话就在我们生活中就消失了。
So we must come back to the word of God.
所以我们一定要回到神的道。
Focus on the word of God.
要专注在神的道。
You see that there.We always talk about evangelism.
我们经常去谈到传福音。
How is it that we don't preach?
为什么我们不传福音呢？
It's an indication of not very serious about the word of God.
那很大一部分的原因是因为我们不是那么看重神的道。
If we are very serious about God's words,
如果我们今天看神的道是严肃看重的。
And we know that the word of God is so good.
我们知道神的话是美好良善。
And indeed, it is so good to us.
它对我们是特别好的。
Then we'll go and tell people.
我们一定会传去跟其他人讲。
We'll tell the good news to others.
我们会将这好信息传给他人。
Because the word is so good to us.
因为这神的道是这么好。
So sometimes you find that, we focus on the wrong things.
所以很多时候我们将自己的焦点放在错的事情。
We are God's servants.
我们是神的仆人
But we are not very faithful to him.
但是我们对他不是那么信实
So with this kind of mindset, do you think we can come before his throne?
所以如果我们有这样子的一个观念一个想法我们能够到他的宝座前吗
Do you think we can draw close to him?
你觉得我们真的能够亲近他吗
I doubt it
我怀疑
So we need to readjust our lifestyle
所以我们要去重新调整自己的生活。
You know, be servants who truly love the word of the Lord.
做一个真的爱神的道、神的话的仆人。
Okay, I think my time is up. Anyway,
我想时间应该到了。
Let's say a silent prayer.
一起低头默祷。